Welcome to Toronto, Canada, for the Mixed Pairs World Bodybuilding Championship. I'm Bill McAtee with Frank Zane, and on stage now, our first competitors, Mary Roberts and Bob Birdsong.
For those of you not familiar with the sport of bodybuilding or mixed pairs bodybuilding, Frank, what are the judges looking for now?
Bill, we're seeing right now round two, the free posing, and in this, the judges are looking for the posing presentation of the couple, how well they move together, how they interpret their music, as well as how well they're developed.
Mary looks a little bit off.
I noticed a little hesitancy, too, myself. I think it may be due to the fact that they probably didn't get enough practice time in. What impresses me about this couple is their massive development. You could see the size of Birdsong's muscles, and Mary Roberts, too, is very finely developed and very good definition as well.
Both are outstanding individual bodybuilders. Bob is a former Mr. America, and Mary Roberts is a former amateur women's champion. Frank, which is more important now, routine or muscular development?
They're equally important, Bill. They have to have it both. They have to be well-developed and move together in unison. Now, here they're a little bit out of sync. Their movements aren't exactly right on together. There you can see the great development of Mary's back. Just a lot of muscle there. Bob has a very thick back. Doesn't show quite as much definition or muscular relief as Mary does in this pose.
Birdsong and Roberts are in good position coming into the second round. They were only 1 point behind the favorites, Dunlap and Pearson, after the compulsories.
Bill, the compulsories are a series of poses that competitors do in order that they may be compared to one another, more or less to see what their general overall muscularity is. And this shows you how important this round is, because there's only one more round left after this, the final pose down.
Mary Roberts and Bob Birdsong winding down their routine. Round two.
They showed a few awkward moments, but overall, it was a fine performance, Bill.
And a nice round of applause from this capacity crowd here in Toronto. We'll be back with more the World Mixed Pairs Bodybuilding Championships in a moment. Back now at the Skyline Hotel, and on stage, Tina Plakinger and Phil Demski. Phil is an amateur.
Yes, Phil is not quite as thickly muscled as Bob Birdsong. However, you can see he's very, very wide. Very wide shoulders and a huge back. Look at that lat spread.
Now, their routine seems more in unison than Mary Roberts and Bob Birdsong, and we'll get a chance to see how the judges equate that with muscularity.
Notice Tina Plakinger shaking a little bit when she holds her pose. This might be a slight deduction of points. Very nice choreographed routine. They move very nicely together. Show their bodies to maximum advantage, I think.
Tina Plakinger and Phil Demski ending their routine.
So that brings up now Diana Dennis and Kevin Lawrence.
I think their training together shows very much in their presentation on stage, Bill. They pay a lot of attention to each other's movements and seem to interact very well.
Neither of them is much involved in individual competition. They are the reigning American couples champions, and this is their specialty.
Yeah, it is. I know Diana does some individual competition, but Kevin is strictly involved in couples competition at this point.
You've had a chance to look at them. Do they have a weakness?
Bill, if I had to find a weakness, I'd have to say that Kevin is a little bit more slender than some of the men in this competition, like Bob Birdsong, for example, and Tony Pearson. He does have very outstanding muscular definition, however.
All right, Diana Dennis and Kevin Lawrence completing their routine. Dunlap. Carla, currently the International Federation of Bodybuilding Women's World Champion. And Tony Pearson, one half of the couple that has won this championship the last 2 years. His previous partner, Shelley Gruhl, is not here. Now, they seem to be having a little trouble with their music, Frank. It's very low. How much is that a factor in their concentration?
Bill, the volume is definitely too low, and I'm not sure that they can even hear the music. And it can really throw them off in their presentation if they react wrong. It's important to act as if everything is okay. And they seem to be doing just that.
I remember you had trouble with your music during the Mr. Olympia contest on Sports World 2 years ago.
Yes, and I think about that every time I see a foul up in the music, such as you see here. They've come out of it very well and acted as if nothing has happened. I don't think it's going to affect them at all. They both show lots of development. Pearson is just tremendously big and very well defined. Carla is sort of on the slender side, but with very good muscular definition. And they complement each other very nicely in their posing. This is a very nice artistic pose. Very beautifully done.
They seem to be encompassing what the judges said they were going to look for. Unique routine and muscular development.
They show very good stage presence as well, Bill, with a lot of charisma and a lot of confidence and good facial expressions. Here they're both doing stomach vacuums and go immediately into an abdominal overhead pose. Very impressive. Very nice. Side chest poses on both of them. Most muscular pose. The routine seems to be a combination of showing quite a bit of muscular development as well as very nice movements.
These two have just finished a very concentrated training period. Tony came up from his home in Atlanta to train with Carla at her home in New Jersey.
Look at the lat spread on Pearson. Huge back development. Pearson looking a little cocky there, showing his most muscular pose, but with all that muscle, I guess he can very well be that way.
Tony Pearson and Carla Dunlap overcoming music problems early in their routine and now getting a fine round of applause from this capacity house here in Toronto. And in this, a sport that is still defining its parameters, perhaps we've seen the right mixture of routine and muscularity.
Cheng and Moses Maldonado.
Both are from New York City. Moses is an American amateur champion. Lydia is the youngest competitor here at the age of 21. She is a French student at New York University.
Bill, while they don't show as much muscle as some of the other competitors, they are a very attractive couple together. Very nice posing routine as well.
Interesting issue in women's bodybuilding now. Femininity versus muscularity. It's an issue that has not been resolved yet.
I think Lydia has a very feminine-looking body and the kind of development that a lot of women would like to have.
A lot of women may want to have this type of body, but how do the judges perceive this?
Well, they were sixth after the first round of compulsory posing, so apparently the judges are looking for a little bit more muscle.
Lydia Cheng and Moses Maldonado.
And we'll be back with the pose down right after.
Right now at the Mixed Pairs World Bodybuilding Championship in Toronto. And we're down to our five finalists. Moses Maldonado, Lydia Cheng, Diana Dennis, and Kevin Lawrence. They're the favorites, Carla Dunlap and Tony Pearson. Bill Demski, he's an amateur, along with Tina Plakinger. And Mary Roberts and Bob Birdsong. This is the pose down. This is a chance for the judges to get one last look, Frank, at the competitors.
It's very much free form, Bill. There's 10 people on stage and they can do whatever they want up there. It's very hard to pick out individually what they look like because of all the people. And it's the last chance for the judges just to make a quick assessment and for the audience to get one final look at who's in the show, who's going to be the top placers.
How much does the audience affect the judging?
I think it can affect it quite a bit. Naturally, the judges are going to react if they hear the audience responding a lot with applause. And they're human just like anybody else. They try to be as objective as possible, but the audience sure helps when they're behind you.
Jacques Blomart, the head judge, as we await the final results.
In fifth place, couple number nine, Lydia Cheng and Moses Maldonado.
So that means Lydia and Moses had a routine good enough to move from sixth place into fifth.
In fourth place, couple number eight, Diana Dennis and Kevin Lawrence.
Fourth place, Diana and Kevin. Does that surprise you a little bit, Frank? Do you expect them to do a little better than that?
Well, they seem a little disappointed to me. I think they expected to get a little bit higher.
They get the check from Ben Weeder, the president of the IFBB.
In third place, couple number one, Tina Plakinger and Phil Demski.
Good finish for Plakinger and Demski, and Frank, Phil being an amateur probably didn't figure to do as well.
He may be an amateur, Bill, but he looks very good on stage. I don't really think he's out of his element in this competition.
And we're down to two.
So the two finalists, Mary Roberts and Bob Birdsong.
In second place.
And Carla Dunlap and Tony Pearson. We're going to hear second place
number three,
first.
Mary Roberts and Bob Birdsong.
Roberts and Birdsong second, so that means our winners, Carla Dunlap and Tony Pearson.
And they seem like very popular winners, judging by the audience reaction, Bill.
Crowds are usually vocal. They let you know in bodybuilding how they feel. And it's evident here that the crowd here in Toronto believes that this is indeed the best couple. Tony Pearson and Carla Dunlap. And here now is another look at our champions, the grace and elegance of their routine. Carla and Tony performing together for the first time.
So that wraps it up here with Carla Dunlap and Tony Pearson, our winners. For Frank Zane, I'm Bill McAtee. So long from Toronto, Canada. Now let's go back to Marv Albert.